Thanks, Chris. If you thought women earning less than men was old news, well, just wait till you hear about another gender divide that makes things even worse. The Retirement Commission's revealed details of the gap in KiwiSaver contributions between men and women. And the end result is far more disparity than the gender gap for pay.
So I think we were very surprised that it is 36%. We knew the gender pay gap was around about 9%, but we weren't aware of the fact of all those compounding factors of time out of paid work and number of people on who are on part-time in part-time positions, that that would have such an influence on that gap. But we were also pleasantly surprised to see that women and men are contributing at the same rate on average. So I think there is a bit of a good news story here too. Women are doing their bit, equal to their male colleagues, and it's really these other inequities within the workplace that are resulting in this very large gap that we see.
Yeah, so break it down. Men and women are contributing the same percentage of their income, but different incomes means different end results. But what are those other compounding factors that Retirement Commissioner Michelle Rye has referred to? Well, Jasmine Hardy-Mills is a KiwiSaver contributor who joins us now. Morena, Jasmine, I appreciate your time on the show this morning. You're also a small business owner. You know this topic inside and out. I've got to say the first number that got to me was, OK, there's a gender pay gap, 8.5%, 9%. 36% by the end, a third less than my partner. That's a shocking number.
It's a massive number, but it's reflective of the time people, women, are taking out of the workforce to have children, to maternity leave, and that returning to part-time work.
So is that the biggest, when we look at those compounding factors, is that the biggest thing that makes a difference to my KiwiSaver being so much less by the end of it? Like, yes, there is a gender gap difference, and so me at 3% is always going to be a smaller number than my partner or husband earning more and still putting in 3%. But is it really? It's the year I take off work or the time that I do childcare that makes the biggest difference?
Well, if I speak to my experience, I joined a retirement savings scheme straight out of uni, did the right thing, maximum savings, all of that. Changed jobs, so joined KiwiSaver in 2009, again, maximum contributions, but had my first child about a year later. When I did return to work, I was part-time. I then went into work for myself, self-employed, and have had two more children over that period. My husband, in comparison, he joined KiwiSaver 10 years later. His balance has overtaken mine. So that 10-year head start I had has really been eclipsed by the three children and the career consequences of having those children.
Yeah, you didn't take a decade off work, but it has resulted in a decade gap. That is incredible, isn't it? And really, I guess, I don't want to sound too depressed about this, but you can't really catch up on that. That gap is gone and it's running away from you.
Yep, and best intentions from the beginning, but what's done is done.
Yeah, do you see any way of being able to close the gap?
I think creating more opportunities for women to work flexibly, allow that return to work, and changing the way we think about work a bit so that women don't get caught out by their career gap that sometimes happens, that women leave work to go and have children and then try and return, and usually return at the same point or slightly below the skill set when they left due to that confidence gap. The things we can do to that would help.
Yeah, what do you see with your clients coming through in the situation that they find themselves in terms of their KiwiSaver contributions?
So the people who work for... I don't.
Well, that's all right. Do you see any way that... Is there any change to legislation that you think would make a difference to this? I mean, I guess it's... I'm not arguing or advocating necessarily that women should get a 4% contribution where men get a 3%. Mm-hmm. Let's say all those things stay the same. Are there other factors that can be changed that would make this fairer through legislation?
It's not really my area of expertise as the legislation per se, but that work environment definitely could be improved. That flexibility, the ability to women to work remotely, COVID has definitely actually done women a bit of a helping hand in terms of that ability to work remotely and those conversations that can happen.
Jasmine Hardy-Mills, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Really appreciate
Thanks.
Your time.